we will use QEMU system I386. And at the end, we will add minus small s and minus big s. So as you can see, nothing's booting. QEMU just waiting for hooking into GDB server. So let's open other terminal. Let's find ID of our container. Let's run bash in it. Okay. And now we should be able to GDB. Of course, we have to go to correct directory, build cbfs fallback, and now we can run GDB. Okay, we have GDB missing, so let's install it. It should be quite fast. Okay, we're in. And you can see that the boot block reading tables were already found. So we can, we are sure we are inside and we have correctly loaded symbols. Unfortunately, there are some limitations of GDB. Despite we will use setArch I8086, GDB still cannot correctly debug 16-bit code at reset vector. But we have access to all the symbols of bootblock, so all the code inside the bootblock can be debugged without the problems. We can add other stages of the boot process, like ROM stage, RAM stage, postcar, by using symbol file, file name, and add symbol file, file name, and providing the address. But there is some small caveat. Symbols in debug files for next stages use different base address and then they are loaded to, so most of the stages are dynamically relocated at runtime. So we have, if we want to load new files at given address, we have to figure out it ourselves. Every next boot stage of coreboot starts in program function. So let's set up a breakpoint on this function. Seems to work, and let's continue. So maybe first let's see that we still are in reset vector. Let's continue, and we see a boot block already executed. So we kind of step it through first stage of booting, and we see that the next stage is ROM stage. But there are some problems to if we want to continue in GDB. So let's list our function and let's look at the proc struct. Can see program function, it takes struct proc to as a parameter. So let's look at the type of a struct proc, and what's interesting here in this struct, of course we don't discuss internals, but this is just an example how we can do debugging and go through the stages. So we see in struct proc, we have struct region device, and in that struct we have a struct region which has some offset, and this offset points to the beginning of the next stage. So let's think how we can use the that information to calculate new stage. On x86, parameters are passed on the stacks, usually from right to left, and call to function pushes also the return address to the stack. So immediately after the entry, the first parameter can be accessed using stack pointer plus 4. This example sets convenience variable pointing, which we can leverage here through some calculation in GDB. So let's try to point to that point to our structure prog. So just let's copy that. And set in GDB. Okay. We can of course read the value of this offset by using print command, but what's most important, we want to point to the region offset which we saw in the structure, and read that value, and of course add symbols files of ROM stage to that address, which will help us in jumping between the stages and using like the same symbols, since the program function in all the stages start the next stage. And in every stage it is called the same. So let's just print the address. And let's use that address for the purpose of adding the symbol file. Of course, we're confirming. And now, if we will continue, we should break at the program of ROM stage. That's good. And of course, what we see here in the other window is that the ROM stage started and continue, and now we could continue the same procedure to obtain postcar address and load the postcar stage into the debugging process. Sometimes it may be a good idea to remove symbols, because if multiple stages use the same symbols, we may hit some conflicts. So, but in this case, this is not the problem. And of course, now when we loaded the ROM stage, we can use ROM stage symbols. And if we want to use symbols from further stages, we of course have to load them in correct way, providing address and so on. So as I said, like, we can follow the same procedure until everything will boot. Alternatively, if debug level is very high, we can redo just the breakpoint and observe the QEMU serial output. And in this case, we showed how the postcard looked like, and also on the terminal we saw the same. Of course, we are interested in the line started with loading module at X, where X is the location, memory location where we load the module. Unfortunately, such line is not printed for boot block to ROM stage transition, because ROM stage is not compressed and is executed in place. So such information is it's not going to the logs.